Well, the history to this is, of course, the longer history of Kashmir, and it's which has been a historic flashpoint between India and Pakistan, and they've gone to war over it several times. The region itself is gets caught up in this warfare. There's, you know, the terrorism and jihadism and all sorts of stuff that's connected to it. At the current moment, though, and I think we have to pay attention to this very much, is that this is very significant that it's happening in an election year for Modi in India, and also that it's Kashmir is not it's been kind of raised as a flashpoint a couple of years ago as well, and is contributing to tension and culture wars between the two countries. So it's something that's quite a complex situation, and it creates a lot of tension for people and uncertainty for people on the ground, as well as it is about state politics, it's about national politics, and it's also about international politics.
So why is it? I mean, it's an extremely complicated matter, as you said, but why is it exactly that Kashmir is such a flashpoint for both countries?
In terms of the border territory and the fact that both the countries have a militarized presence that, as I've said, contributes to culture wars and leads to kind of a lack of cultural collaboration between India and Pakistan. And I think we have seen that it's a, in the increasing politics of Modi's politics have been to have quite an authoritarian presence, and that authoritarian presence is beefed up by a stronger militarized presence in Kashmir. And also, it's for Pakistan, it's complicated. We've got Prime Minister Imran Khan in from the PTI in power at the moment, who has expressed an indication and a willingness for a peace process, but his rise to power has also been seen as partly something that has been supported by the military as well as the people's mandate. So to what extent can he actually exercise what he personally wants, and also what the vested interests around him will want to show and to express to India, that this is a no-go zone for Pakistan? We've had the Cold War in the 1980s as well, which has involved the USA and the rise of militancy in Pakistan, and that in itself is something, you know, the blowback for Pakistan has also been a very big thing. But over here, I think internationally, what is also something that really needs a lot of attention is the region of Kashmir itself, and the fact that there needs to be a solution and a mandate that is decided for those who are being affected by Kashmir, by this kind of warmongering by two sides, which is goes back to colonial history, goes back to 1947, goes back to partition, goes back to the unfinished business, as they say, of partition.